welcome back to the Alexa Style Book. Hope everybody has been doing well. In today's video, it's going to be an exciting video because we are going to go on a journey to find the best, most comfortable and affordable pair of high heels. And I've been looking and searching for the perfect pair for such a long time. And so I'm going to review a couple brands here for you so that hopefully this information can help you find the perfect pair of high heels for you too. So without further ado, let's dive into our video. The first pair of heels that I have here with me is from Zara. It is these cute little babies right here, and they are in a nude color, as you can see. I just literally picked this up last week, so I have not worn it outside yet, but I have, however, been walking in them inside just to see and get a feel on to how they feel on my feet, and I have to say they are super, super comfortable so far. These shoes are made of 100% leather, and they come in this cute little pointed heel detail style right here, and they are very dainty. Let me put this one down. They are so dainty and very elegant. As you can see, it has a really nice silhouette for the heel in the back, and then the shoe itself is very slim. However, it's not tight or uncomfortable when I slip my feet into them, and they look like this on the toe box right here. And I especially love this pair of heels because right off the bat, as I slip my feet into the heels, the toe box does not feel like it's constraining my toes, so I feel very comfortable resting my feet into the toe box area here. So I have to give it props for the toe box, because even though it is a pointed heel, the toe box is wide enough so that when you put your feet inside the shoe, it does not feel very constrained and it doesn't hurt your toes or anything like so. And the footbed is very cushioned. It's lightly cushioned, but like I said, I felt very comfortable when I slipped my feet in here, so it was no complaint at all. Though I have not been standing up in these for a long time, so I can't really tell yet that it is going to be super comfortable for an all-day wear. However, first impression, as I slipped my feet into the shoe and I've been standing in it for about 15-20 minutes, and I felt very comfortable. I think that's partly due to the heel height. This is around 3.1 inches. So before I forget, this shoe retails for around $69.90, which I find is a really good price for a pair of 100% leather heels. And it is so comfortable. The style is awesome. I would definitely recommend this to anybody to try out because it is such an awesome shoe. This shoe right here was not on sale, so it is from their newest collection right now, so you can definitely find it at Zara.com. I'm going to link it down in the description bar down below. If you're interested in it, please look there and you'll find the link. Okay, so moving on to our second pair of heels I have here with me from Walking Cradles. These are the cute Sophia Pump, and it is in a white color. This is 100% leather, and I really love leather shoes because I find them most comfortable. So whenever I'm looking for a pair of heels or looking for investment in a pair of shoes, then I always try to find 100% leather heels or shoes. So this is the Sophia Pump, and it is in the color called White Cashmere. It's just a white leather pump, and it is very cute, so comfortable. I love Walking Cradles, love the technology, the comfort cushion that they have with their designs. So this is one of my favorite pair of heels that I have in my collection. It is made from Brazil, and it is the more kitten heels, I believe. This is around 2.14 inches. So this heel is perfect for walking. It's very comfortable. I've worn this many times, and I've already been walking in this for around 6 to 8 hours at a time, and they are very comfortable. So these are wide, and I'm so glad glad that I picked these up in wide, because even though they are, they gap a little bit when I put my feet through, when I wear them, they gap on the side just a tiny bit, but because of that, it gives my feet room to move. It's not too big where it slides on and off when I'm walking, and the heels, it just fit perfectly. So I love these shoes for that. And the other thing that I love about this shoe is the technology on the cushioning bed right here. It is very, very comfortable. It has these little soft pillow cushions right here that provides a little bit of an extra comfort when you're walking in them. It provides a little bit of resilience when you're walking, so I love that. And it has a little arch support on the side right here, so which is a plus. And the inside is lined with all leather, so I really find this shoe, no negatives about it. It's the most comfortable shoe that I have in a high heel form. And as you can already tell, I love the style of heels with the pointed toe box, and I always try to find the shoe that has a more pointed toe box because I feel like they're very elegant. They help to kind of elongate your legs and elongate the foot a little bit, so it makes your feet look a little longer and skinnier, and so overall it gives you a more elongated silhouette. So that's the reason why I think they are so chic and I love that style. So for the third pair of heels, it is by Rockport, and it is these cute ones right here. It is called the Gale Pump, and they are just so adorable. It has a chunkier heel in the back here, and I believe this one is one of the only ones that I have in my heel collection here that has a chunkier heel, a block heel. And this one is called the Gale Pump. It is also 100% premium leather upper, and it has the leather wrap around to the back of the heels also right here, as you can see. This is, I believe, also in a 7.5. However, these are so big on me. I don't know why. They're not wide. They are 7.5 regular medium size. And when I walk, they just slip off my heels and they just don't stay on. I don't understand why. I do often put a little heel cover or heel cushion in the back here. That helps the shoe to stay on. But it's just amazing to me how sizes different between different brands. It's just a little bit frustrating and annoying sometimes. But these run big, so I would definitely say if you are going to buy these shoes, maybe size down a little bit. And if you have a narrow feet, definitely size down. If you do have a bigger, wider feet, then maybe stick to the regular size. This is in a 7.5, and I love the cushioning in this shoe. Like the cushioning, I think the cushioning system is called the Eva cushioning system, and it's one of the best I've seen so far, because the pillows here and the pillows in the back of the heels, it's just so soft. It has memory foams, so all day comfort is definitely true with this shoe right here. And this has an almond shaped toe heel, which is very classic and very, very elegant at the same time. This silhouette is quite cute, very elegant and classic, so I definitely love this also. And I, like I said, the only complaint I have with this shoe is that it runs a little big and the heels often slip off whenever I wear without a heel cushion. So I definitely have to say size down if you are interested in getting these heels right here. The comfort is a 10 out of 10 because of the cushioning in the footbed right here that provides all day comfort with the memory foam. Alright, so the heel height on these is around 2.5 inches, and that's definitely the comfort height heel for me. I love that, the fact that it's only 2.5 inches, and it gives you a little boost, but it's not super high where your feet feels like it's dipping down the whole day. Okay, so let's move on to the fourth pair, and these are by Kohans, and I believe these are called the Amelia Pump, and they are just so adorable. Oh my gosh, I love the silhouette. set of these. They are so pretty. And these right here, I believe it's 100% premium leather also. And the leather is so, so nice. They're so supple. When you touch it, it feels very, very smooth, very sleek, buttery, soft. And I like the fact that this shoe, a lot of shoe is 100% leather, but the leather still is very stiff. I don't know if you can see what I'm saying, but the leather sometimes they're 100% leather, but they're not as soft as these. These are super, super soft. And the construction of these right along the edges here, it curves inside. So it lines a little bit inside too. So because of that, it makes the shoe very comfortable at these edges right here. It provides all the comfort that you would need all day. The only complaint I have with these is this pointed toe, but the toe box is quite small. So I still feel like when I put my feet in there, the toes are a little bit constrained, or it's kind of squished my toes a little bit. So that part right there is really, really hard to stand all day in because the toes box right here is kind of slim and very small, so it doesn't feel as comfortable. That's my only complaint with this shoe. Otherwise, it's quite beautiful. So the cushioning in this shoe is so amazing. It is called the Grand OS cushioning system by Cole Haans, and I love their cushioning system. It makes the shoe very comfortable, but it makes it very light also, so you don't feel like it's weighing you down whenever you're walking, and it's very comfortable and light when you walk, like I said. So I definitely have to give props to Cole Haans for that. That is one of the best technology out there for cushioning system. Light and comfortable at the same time. It's very, very hard and high quality. Anyway, so the only complaint is that this shoe at the bottom is a little slippery. So before you wear them, if you're going to get a shoe like so, you have to kind of get something to kind of mat it down a little so that you don't fall or slip whenever you're walking on the concrete. That's the only issue I have with the bottom of the shoe right there. And this one I believe is in a 7.5, and it is in a medium, 7.5 medium size, normal size, not narrow and not wide. And then the other thing that I love about this shoe is that in the back of the heel right here, it has an extra cushioning pad right here that helps you to feel very comfortable when you slip the shoe on. And so I really, really love that about this shoe. Overall, the heel height is perfect. It is around 3.14 inches, which is around 3.25 inches. So not too bad with the heel height. Still not that tall. Very slim heel, gives you a perfect elongated silhouette. So the last two pair of heels that I have to show you is from the same company. It is by Sesto Miushi, and these are what they look like. Oh, they are so, so beautiful, don't you think so? Oh my gosh, I love these pair of shoes. I love the silhouette. It has also a pointed heel toe style box, and then it is in such a lovely colors. This is in cognac, and I believe this is just in the nude color. And the style is very similar, or exactly the same, not very similar, exactly the same. It has a pointed heel. I guess it has a smaller square heel, but it's still very sleek at the same time. I definitely love this company. The leather is so amazing. It is 100% premium leather. However, it's not as super soft as the Cole Haans. The leather is very nice still, but like I said, not super soft like the Cole Haans is. It is very comfortable. It has a very nice cushiony footbed, and I believe, let me put this one down, I believe this is cushion, yes, all throughout the footbed. So I love this nude color. It is a little bit darker than my skin tone. However, I feel like it goes with so many things. It is a bit different than my Zara nude heels. Hold on, This is the Zara nude color. So the Zara one is a little bit lighter than the Sesto Mushi nude color. However, I love both colors and I love how they are very versatile. You can wear them with so many, many things because they are great neutrals. So yes, I'm glad that I have both of them in my collection. Okay, so back to this pump. This is just, I believe the style or model name is the Sesto Mushi pointed toe pump. I don't believe there's like a name, an official name to it, but this is so nice. It is very comfortable. The toe box, again, I have a hard time with toe box that are very slender, very tight and constricting. I do have to say that this shoe does have a very tight toe box. So if I was to recommend it, I definitely recommend to size up half a size, so that it's more comfortable at the toe box area right here. It does come in wide, and I believe they don't have any wide available right now where I pick these shoes up. So if you do have a wider feet, I definitely have to do some research to see if they're available. But they come in this nice cognac color, the nude color, black color, red, a lot of variety, navy color, a Peyton. I think I saw a pair of black Peyton heels in these too. So there's a lot of colors to choose from if you're interested in these shoes right here. Very high quality leather, and the heel is very classic. It's not super pointy like the Zara heels or the Kohans. However, this is very classic, and I feel like this will not go out of style anytime soon. The silhouette of them, very nice. It makes your feet very elongated and very slim look. Heights on these is around 3.25 inches. Not super high and not super low either. So they give you a nice boost, a nice height, a lift, but also keeping it very comfortable for you to walk throughout the day. I do love the silhouette, like I said, and I love the leather that it made out of. So yes, definitely recommend. Alright, so to wrap up, let me give you my final thoughts on what I think about the couple of heels that we have reviewed and looked at in this video. I definitely think for style, comfort, and price, the best one out of all the shoes that I've shown you, I would definitely have to recommend the Zara pumps. I know that we went through many different pair of shoes that is at great price, but I just feel that the toe box in the Zara heels makes it very easy to wear. The quality of the shoe is 100% premium leather, and then the price is only around $69.90, and the heel height and the heel shape and the silhouette of the shoe overall is so pretty that I definitely would have to give it to the Zara pumps. If you can only choose one pair of heels to start off with, I would definitely go with the Zara pumps first. It comes in a nude color and it comes in a black color. It also comes in a metallic gold color, red color, and I believe navy color also. So there's many options for you to choose from. I would definitely go with the Zara heels first because for style, it is on point. Alright, so my recommendation for the most comfortable pair of heels, but not as modern of a silhouette, maybe more of a classic silhouette, I would definitely recommend Rockport or even the Walking Cradles, because I feel like those two companies have the most comfortable pair of shoes that I've tried out of all of them. It has very nice cushioning system. However, the silhouette of those shoes are not as modern as something like Zara or something that looks like Sesto Mushi or even Kohans. They're more classic and they're more along the line where it is an older, more vintage look. However, I still like those classic looks, so I definitely would recommend that for anybody who's looking for that type of silhouette at the moment. And then lastly, for Kohans and Sesto Mushi, definitely love the silhouette of those shoes. Definitely have to say that they are very pretty on the feet. They make my feet look so slim, great silhouette. However, I felt that the toe box is very tight, very constrained to the feet. So because of that, it is very hard to walk in them for a long period of time. I can't even do 6 or 8 hours in them, probably maybe maximum is 2 or 3 hours because of how tight they are. So if I have to say that you're going for style and you like those shoes because the quality is there, Kohans and Sesto Mushi has the best premium leather, very nice silhouette, and quality is really, really nice. Out of all of them, those have the greatest quality. However, just because of the comfort, I would definitely have to recommend the other ones first before I recommend the Kohan or the Sesto Mushi. If you are to size up, I believe that it will be a little bit better. I'm just not sure if they are going to provide an all-day comfort because it would be super annoying at the toe box, which makes it so tight over there. Going up a size might help with that. I'm not sure if that's gonna alleviate the whole problem. So right now I would have to say stick with Walking Cradles, stick with Rocksport, and then stick with Zara. Zara will provide you with the best modern look, and then also the comfort level is there for those for that pair of shoes. So yes, those are my thoughts on this video. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like these type of videos, please do let me know so I can get more out there for you. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so that we can stay in touch and see each other in the next video. If you have any questions for me, link it down below and I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope to see you in the next video. See you later. Bye.